Alrighty. Hi, my name is Austin Parenti. I'm a writer and director for Flamingo Heist. Making two features has taught me that in every mistake is a new opportunity to actually make things better than they would have been. It's turned me into a bit of an optimist. So we're expecting that through this process of making Flamingo Heist, we're going to encounter more and more problems. And we're gonna fight to have an optimistic attitude that says when those problems come our way, you know what? There's an opportunity here for us to try something new, to improvise, and perhaps the film will turn out better because of it, just like they always have. So that's what we're hoping you'll see in this BTS, is a bunch of problems that we resolve with some good optimism, determination, and improvisation. And maybe, just maybe, you too will say that Flamingo Heist was better for the problems.
Pretty fun.
So, I remember, maybe one of you can remind me, I remember about this time last year we were meeting to talk about the wreck of Echo 10-4.
Yeah.
I remember pointing at the poster of the Fountain of Youth and saying, somehow, some way, we made a movie. And we did a decent enough job that we were welcome back for round two, and that sometime soon we would be looking at a poster of that film completed, and we could view it and see that your hard work paid off. And that is true, and it's going to be true again. We're in for round three, three times a charm. I'm really, really excited for this project. I think it's going to delight your souls as you work on it. I really believe you guys are in for the summer of your lives. I am so excited about this. This is the coolest thing ever. A new building with a new studio just for us. There's other departments in there too, but we're really, really excited. We're really, really blessed. So it might be done in time for Flamingo Heist, but if there are any delays with technology or other resources, the building might not be ready for use. So we've actually planned to shoot the entire film without it, but if a location falls through, and this is ready, this will be our backup. So I'm gonna take the crew up there today to see how we would use it if we can. So let's go check it out. So on the right is our new studio. We're gonna temporarily call it, I guess, Soundstage A. And further down ahead will be our kind of primary tech classroom with computers and such. And here is the smaller film lab where we'll have advanced film and TV production. Soundstage A. Pretty cool, right? Imagine the LED wall pretty much comes to that window and goes and goes and goes and then wraps all the way around. It'll go just a little higher than the base of those windows as well. So for Flamingo, we currently have tried to secure every location in person in the event that this space isn't complete for whatever reason why. Technologically or if there's some sort of building problem. But if a location falls through, last minute, we're gonna be in here.
I'm Ziyan Zheng. I'm a senior at the King's Academy and about to graduate in June 1st. And I'm the co-director of Flamingo Heist. Location scouting means we will go to the location before the shooting day and we take a bunch of pictures. And then we use those pictures to build a floor plan in the app called Shotify. And then we just design the shots based on the location.
I'm Ryan Cavanaugh, and I am the camera operator for this film. So shot listing is essentially the pre-production aspect of camera team's job. We choose what shots are going to be happening throughout the script for each scene. And so we'll just go scene by scene and choose, all right, for this moment, we want it on a medium close-up, and then we want to cover this in a medium shot. And so on the day of, when we're filming that scene, we know, all right, we need to get a medium shot of this line, we need to get a wide shot of this, whatever it is that we chose earlier.
In pre-production, the art department meets with the directing staff, so myself and Christy, and discusses the aesthetic feel of the film. So me and Christy took many, many weeks to try and draft a vision for the story, color, light, textures. We share that with the art team, and then they spend all of pre-production acquiring the props and costume and set pieces that we need to bring that vision to life. It's a grueling task, really. They have to go through every single scene and itemize every single physical object that should be in the scene, and then they're in charge of finding it. So they've done a marvelous job, Allison, and she had help from a production designer, Summer Hoskins.
All right, Allison, how's art stuff going?
Good. Last time I spoke to Summer, a lot of the stuff was coming in, and so we're pretty set. We just need to meet with our team, I think, now and make sure they all know what's happening.
So we're still waiting on some of the costumes to come in. We're waiting on a couple props, but for the most part, we're pretty prepared. The hardest part about the art team, I would say, is that we're still guesstimating some of the sizes for the actors based on their headshots. So we kind of have to see what will fit and figure out how we can resize things once they get here.
What could possibly go wrong?
I think the main thing that could possibly go wrong is being unorganized and not having our costumes together and ready for each scene, just making sure that all the props are on set when we need them. I'm most excited to work with the students that are on the team. I don't really know them yet, but I'm looking forward to getting to know them and just seeing their artistic abilities with the film.
So is there any room for flexibility?
We have a lot of options, I would say. Once all the locations are finalized, we'll definitely get those figured out, but we have to make sure that from scene to scene, the sets look the same so that each part of the film is,
okay.
I don't know the word I'm looking for, consistent.
I got that totally wrong. My wife's due date is August 1st, and this is our first child. So it's especially important that we're all together as a family for this really amazing moment. Our film wraps July 29th, so it's possible he'll come early and I'll just have to step away from the production for the last week or maybe even two, possibly more. Of course, we hope not. But if that happens, Christy is gonna take over and direct for us, and I'm so excited for her to do that. I have full faith in her, but it will be kind of weird to just walk away from a production no matter what on the day of my son's birth.
Roll sound. Sound speed. Roll camera.
Camera speed.
Scene 47A. Scene 47A, take one.
Alright, set.
And action.
Which way am I going?
Skywalker was a strapping young lad, had to wait out the harvest, it made him real mad, so he stared across the prairie at the binary suns, wondering when his time would come to have some dumb fun. Thankfully, some gadgetry on Luke's droid abnormally, R2 the blue, he played a May Day from Princess Leia, she say, help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi.